In order to solve a radical equation containing one radical, we want to start by isolating the radical on one side of the equation. Then we want to raise both sides of the equation to the power of the index. This will undo the radical, and then we'll solve the resulting equation and check our solutions. Looking at our first example, we have the square root of the quantity 2x minus 7 equals 9. Notice how the square root is already isolated on the left side of the equation. And because we have a square root, the index is 2, so we can undo the square root by squaring both sides of the equation. Again, when we square a square root, this will simplify to just the radicand, or 2x minus 7. And then on the right side, 9 squared is equal to 81. And now we'll solve this basic two-step linear equation, and then check our solution. So the next step would be to add 7 on both sides. So we have 2x equals 88. Divide both sides by 2. And we have x equals 44. And now to make sure this solution actually works, we'll substitute 44 for x into the original equation. So we would have the square root of 2 times 44 minus 7 equals 9. Well, 2 times 44 is going to be 88. 88 minus 7 is 81. So we have the square root of 81 equals 9. And since the square root of 81 is equal to 9, our solution works, and therefore our solution checks. Let's take a look at our second example now. Again, the first step is to isolate the square root on the left side of the equation. So to undo this minus 8, we'll start by adding 8 to both sides of the equation. So we'd have the square root of x plus 3 equals negative 3 plus 8 is positive 5. And again, because we have a square root and the index is 2, we're going to square both sides of the equation. The square root of the quantity x plus 3 squared will just be x plus 3. 5 squared is equal to 25. So to solve for x, we'll subtract 3 on both sides of the equation. And we have x equals 25 minus 3 is equal to 22. And now to check the solution, we'll substitute 22 for x into the original equation. So we'd have the square root of 22 plus 3, that's 25. So the square root of 25 minus 8 equals negative 3. Well, the square root of 25 would be 5. 5 minus 8 is equal to negative 3. So that does check. And therefore, our solution is x equals 22. We'll take a look at some more examples in the next video.